France and Germany have agreed to develop a new generation European fighter jet together that will replace their current fleets. French President Emmanuel Macron called it a revolution in their defense relations. A statement from the French presidency after talks between German Chancellor Angela Merkel and Macron in Paris said, the two partners hope to finalize a joint roadmap by mid-2018. Macron added that fighter jets are heavy projects for our armies and our governments, and a joint European aircraft would help save money and remove competition between different jets currently on the market. He further added that the aim of this joint fighter jet project is to do research and development together, to use it together, and to coordinate on exports. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the joint French and German 6th generation fighter. Let's get started. Dassault Rafales and Eurofighter Typhoon are currently the most advanced fighter jet deployed by France and Germany, respectively. Rafale is a twin-engine canard delta wing multi-role fighter aircraft designed and built by Dassault Aviation. Equipped with a wide range of weapons, the Rafale is intended to perform air supremacy, interdiction, aerial reconnaissance, ground support, in-depth strike, anti-ship strike, and nuclear deterrence missions. The Rafale is referred to as an omni-role aircraft by Dassault. The Eurofighter Typhoon is a twin-engine canard delta wing multi-role fighter. Typhoon program is multinational collaboration between the UK, Germany, Italy, and Spain. The Eurofighter Typhoon is a highly agile aircraft designed to be a supremely effective dogfighter in combat. Later production aircraft have been increasingly better equipped to undertake air-to-surface strike missions and to be compatible with an increasing number of different armaments and equipments. Both Rafale and Typhoon are referred to as 4.5 generation fighters, and there is no plan for a 5th generation fighter. US has moved ahead with deploying F-35 5th generation fighter, apart from having F-22 Raptor. Several partner nations like the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Turkey, Australia, Norway, and Denmark, and allies like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighters. Russian 5th generation Su-57 has been unveiled last year and even made a short appearance in Syria. Designed by Sukhoi Corporation, Su-57 is a stealth, single-seat, twin-engine, multi-role fighter developed for air superiority and ground attack operations. China has also deployed its own 5th generation J-20, developed by Chengdu Aerospace Corporation. It's a single-seat, twin-jet, all-weather stealth fighter aircraft. The announcement of cooperation between France and Germany comes at a time when US President Donald Trump has been prodding Europe to do more with respect to defense and be less dependent on America. In late April of this year, on the sidelines of an air show in Berlin, France and Germany have signed a 10-page common requirements document that outlines the required capabilities at a very high level. The aircraft will have low observable characteristics so that it can penetrate enemy's air defenses. The fighter will be equipped with very powerful sensors, including a synthetic aperture radar that will be able to scan the airspace at long ranges. These features are reminiscent of 5th generation fighters, but the upcoming fighter is likely to go far beyond and add many new capabilities. The fighter may have the ability to manage stealthy drones deploying both kinetic weapons and electronic warfare systems, a concept known as manned-unmanned teaming. It may also include laser weapons, advanced cybersecurity to protect against hacking, and AI-enabled autopilot. Initial work on the jet will be started from this year itself and is expected to be operational by 2040. Apart from improving ties, pooling resources together makes sense, as developing a high-profile fighter is very cost-intensive and requires a huge amount of effort. The plane will be the first stealthy plane developed in Europe. The idea is to combine the technical prowess of very capable companies like Airbus, Dassault, Thales, MBDA, and Safran to develop a potent fighter jet. After the base work is done, the program could be expanded to include British firms like BAE Systems and Swedish firm Saab, which is the maker of JAS-39 Gripen. It will be extremely important to have a solid management to get the coordination right, and if done in the proper way, the fighter could turn out to be a world beater.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.